Hey, you guys, I think the coast is clear. You can come out now.
Israel had such a rough ride and so many ups and downs that a bucking bronco would seem more like the pony ride outside the thrifty mart. They had great victories, but just when things were all fat, dumb, and happy, Israel would end up and just start being plain old dumb. Sometimes they were dumber than a gunny sack full of rocks. They go out and start sinning against God, and that led to humiliating defeat and oppression. Each time when things got bad enough, Israel, bellowing like a lost calf, would come crawling back, crying out to God for deliverance. Each time, God would show his mercy and raise up a man or woman to lead Israel to victory. Well, this time, the Midianites were the ones doing all the cattle rustling, and for good measure, throwing in a little crop destroying. The Bible says they were like locusts, totally devastating all the land. One thing you can always count on, when God's children cry out to him, he hears them. First, God sent a prophet to refresh his children's memory and to encourage them.
Thus says the Lord, the God of Israel, it was I who brought you up from Egypt and brought you out of the house of slavery. And I delivered you from the hands of the Egyptians and from the hands of all your oppressors and drove them out before you and gave you their land. And I said to you, I am the Lord your God. You shall not fear the gods of the Amorites in whose land you live, but you have not obeyed me.
After the prophet's announcement, a messenger visited this guy named Gideon and set God's plan for mess solving into motion.
Yes, son, but hurry. You can work with the grain here in the wine press. It's not the season for suburbs, and I don't think the Midianites will think to look here for any room.
But we gotta be very careful, because the fire we get from this wheat will have to last us a long time.
You are to not stand guard. And if we're able to sneak another bundle in later, you can stand guard and hide your heart.
Give me a sign.
Gideon needed more evidence that the message he was being given was from the Lord. He wasn't about to buy a pig in a poke. God obliged by sending fire that consumed the meal Gideon had prepared for this stranger. Now, this Gideon fellow was a little thick-headed, but when it finally dawned on him that the messenger was an angel from the Lord, it brought Gideon incredible peace in spite of the circumstances.
Get on your feet, get along down the street. Joy and
have to defend him? If I was an all-powerful god and somebody tore down my altar, I would want to get revenge myself. Let Bell fight for himself. Yeah, I like the sound of that. Let Bell fight for himself. I think I changed Gideon's name to Jerubal, which means let Bell fight against him.
No. We can't do that. Why have we got to keep the name Gideon?
But the sixth chapter of Judges clearly states that I changed Gideon's name to Jerubal. Shouldn't we keep the story as close to the real thing as possible?
Well, sure, but, well, I guess we can try. All right, we're going to make this change. Let's give it a shot. All right, let's say it one time.
Giddalong Gideon.
No. Somebody give me a Bible. Okay, cancel that change, because right here in chapter 7, he's referred to both as Gideon and Jerubbaal. So, we're going to keep Gideon. Now, everyone back to your places, and here we go.
Well, Gideon, I guess they got this name thing straightened out, but you're not finished with what the Lord wants you to do.
What do you mean?
Remember earlier I told you that the Lord wanted you to deliver Israel from the hands of Midian?
Oh yeah, about that. I've been thinking, if the Lord is really going to use me as you say, I think I need more to go on. I need to ask the Lord for a sign.
What did you have in mind?
I thought I would leave this piece of wool out here on the threshing floor overnight and ask the Lord to make the wool damp with dew in the morning and keep the ground around it dry. If that happens, then I know what he said is true.
That wasn't enough for Gideon. He had to have one more sign. If it was me, I'd be thinking about giving him the old rattlesnake in the bedroll sign about now. But God's a mite more patient than your average cowpoke. Once more, he provided the exact sign Gideon asked for. Finally, Gideon, along with 32,000 men, prepared to fight the Midianites.
Thank you.
Hey, there's three men, and there are still too many. I'm sure you have a plan to reduce the numbers, don't you?
I thought you'd never ask. Take all the men down to the stream, those who are only concerned with drinking, and kneel down to lap the water up like a dog. You don't want them. The ones you do want are the ones who kneel down and dip the water out of the stream with their hands and then drink with their hands.
You mean they have to think about how they drink?
Well, I guess you're right, but they won't know what to do.
Anything else?
You can lead your horse to water, but you can't make them think.
Right.
Kind of shocks you right out of your boots, doesn't it? Gideon doing something just as the Lord directed. I know it's hard to believe, but he did, and as a result, ended up with only 300 men. That night, the Lord continued his plan and again spoke to Gideon.
Why don't you take a servant down and sneak down to the camp with the Midianites? You might be interested in what you discover.
Thank you.
Gideon, thanks to your obedience and courage, Israel is now free from the oppression of the Midianites.
I'm sure the word has spread quickly.
Boy, our family's going to be happy.
Always be sure that He will be your peace for the journey, your strength for the struggles, and your source for the victory.